Welcome back, SethBling here, and today I want to show you a concept I came up with for a Redstone sequential combo lock. My friend's son was asking me if I knew a way to do this, and off the top of my head I couldn't think of anything, so I came to the Redstone lab and I built what I could. So I'm going to show you how it works, and I'll also show you in this video how to build it for yourself. So first of all, let me enter the combo and show you the lock in action. It's 2, 3, 2, 1, 1, and the door opens. And so to clear the combo, you can just press any button, it'll clear it, and the door will close. You can use this button to get out. Whoops. Yo! So I'll show you how this works. It works based on the properties of repeater locks. So if you have a repeater pointing at another repeater, and the repeater that's pointing into the other repeater is powered, it'll lock the state of the other repeater. So here, this repeater, even though it's not reading a signal, there's nothing powering it. Because it's locked, it's still turned on because that's the state it was in. And so this is used to lock in combo states. And so this set of five repeater locks is actually something called a shift register. So if I press the button, here, we'll see the first elements turn on and all the other ones are off. If I press another button, they'll all shift to the right by one. Well, no matter what, they'll all shift to the right by one. So here it's on the second one. If I press another button again, now it's on the third one. If I press this button, they'll all shift, but the newest element will be on. And so this is my shift register. And it, basically it's caused by all of these repeaters pulsing off for a very short amount of time, allowing the signal of this repeater chain to make it one block farther or one repeater farther. And so maybe you can see this redstone on top pulse off real quick, right? Just pulses off real quick and allows the repeater locks to unlock for a moment. You can actually see the repeater locks unlocking. And so that's what's going on with this button. This button is exactly the same. This button's exactly the same. They're just kind of covered up with some redstone, so it's a little bit harder to see. The pistons on top, these are just visual. You don't need these at all. I added them in so that it'd be a little bit easier to see. So let me enter the combo. 2, 3, 2, 1. Whoops, that one didn't actually take. And 1. And so now we'll see the combo represented these pistons, 2, 3, 2, 1, 1. It goes from back to front because the back are the older presses, the front are the newer presses. And so the pistons show you what's going on, but what's actually happening and how the lock works is this line, this red line of redstone controls the door. If this torch is on, then the door is open. And so this line of redstone comes from back here. And so there's actually three lines of redstone that feed into this line. And that's one for each button. And so all of these three lines of redstone need to be completely unpowered for the door to open. And what's going on? Again, remember the combo is 2, 3, 2, 1, 1. So you can see that here, 2, 3, 2, 1, 1. Wherever the combo element is supposed to be on, there's a repeater. If it's supposed to be off, there's a torch. So the torch inverts the signal. And these read from, basically, they read from the repeater. So the repeater lock is going into this block, and the torch inverts that, and then there's another torch that inverts that again, if it's on or off. But so down here, we're just kind of reading from the shift register and making sure that it matches the combo. And if they all check out, then the redstone torch down here can turn on, the door can open. And pressing any button is gonna shift everything down by one, and that will, unless your combo is like 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, it's definitely going to clear the combo and it'll close the door. And so anytime you want, you can always just start the combo afresh. And in this case, it's 2, 3, 2. That one was, yeah, you have to give a little bit of a delay between pressing the buttons, so I didn't give quite enough. 1, 1. The pistons actually do help you here when you've successfully entered a combo element. So that is actually a nice feature. But okay, and that opens it. So now I'll show you how to build it for yourself. I'm going to use BlingEdit to make this go a lot faster. So I added a new feature to BlingEdit, which lets you clone in place. So if I select this region and hit clone, the clone region will already be selected right here. And so I can move it to the right by 2. Let's clone and repeat 1, 2, 3, 4 times. So now I've got 4 copies of this structure. that's all of them that I need for a single button, but I'm gonna need three buttons. So we clone, we move this region to the right three times, three blocks, and clone and repeat twice. So now we can have three buttons. Now I want to pick my combo. In this case, I've decided I want my combo to be 1, 2, 3, 2, 1. So I'm going to break torches going from the back here. This is going to be the back. The buttons will be up there. So 1, 2, 3, 2, 1. And then all of the spots I just broke a torch, I'm going to put down a repeater facing the line of redstone. And that is how you encode your combo, whatever combo you pick. Next, we're going to build the shift register. And so to do that, you place three blocks like this, break this one, put a redstone torch here and redstone dust here. Then you're going to need a repeater going into that block and a repeater locking it and some blocks underneath it and in front of it. And then we'll also need a line of redstone that goes over the whole thing. And it looks like this. So this is what you need to build. You need to build that a bunch of times. I'm going to use my copy and paste from Bling Edit because it's way faster. So let's select this region, clone. Let's move it right two blocks and clone and repeat, 3, 4, okay. And so that's one combo element, but I need one for each button. So let's do that again, select the region. Let's clone this, move it right three blocks, 1, 2, 3, and clone and repeat twice. And there we go. So now that's the shift register. And I'll show you how that works in a moment. But we'll need a repeater going into each of these to make sure that the signal strength is high enough for the signal to reach all the way to the end. And then similarly, we want to refresh the strength of the signal coming out of each of these lines. So we'll put a repeater in each of these spots. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. That's the max length of a redstone signal from this repeater. And we'll add another repeater in here. And this line is what will actually power the door. Okay, so that's good to go. Then we also need a line of redstone here, which will end up powering the or pulsing basically for the shift registers. Okay, so now we're gonna build the actual button that's for the three buttons. So put a block next to this repeater and then a block on each face of that and break the middle one. And then let's do that for each of the three buttons. Now we want a repeater going into this, into each of these. So those are gonna go into the line of locked repeaters. We also need a line of redstone underneath, and I'll show you what that looks like in a second. But let's put that line of redstone down. And so now, let me put down the buttons. So I'm using diamond here to indicate these are user-facing blocks. So the user will actually be able to see these, whereas all the iron ones can be hidden away. So now we have some buttons. These are the actual buttons that you're gonna press as part of the lock. Notice that when I press these buttons, the line down here lights up. And when I press these buttons, this line also lights up. So this line here is what's going to actually trigger the pulse that will control the shift registers. So at the end of this line, we put a block and then torch on top of that and a block on top of that, a block next to it, and also next to this. So we put down two repeaters, one here, one here. This one can stay on the default length, but this one needs to be a delay of 4. Then we put a block here and a block here, and we read the signals. This one doesn't need one there. Read the signals coming out of it like this. And so now we have a pulser, and actually the whole thing is done. So I'm gonna extend this out a little bit farther so we can see this line of redstone. Remember, this line of redstone, when it turns off, the door will open. So the combo was 1, 2, 3, 2, and watch that line of redstone, and it turns off. The combo lock works. You can sort of see on the side, this one has the middle element on from the repeater locks. It's a little bit harder to see the repeater locks for these other ones. Kind of have to get up in the machinery, but you can see them. So now we just need to build the actual door. I like to do it about like this. Let's put a redstone torch here and let's make sure this gets powered by the line of redstone. Some diamond blocks And this is where the door is going to go. Now the door should be open right now because the combo has actually been entered. If I press a button though, the combo will get cleared and the door closes. I can use Bling Edit to real quickly just add some, add a floor here, fill with diamond blocks. And there we go. We got a floor and we're good to go. 1, 2, 3, 2, 1. And again, you might want to put a little button on the inside here so that once you do clear the combo and go through the door, that door is going to be closed so you can get back out using that button. You'll have to enter the combo to get back in again. That's how it works. That's how you build it. If you want to extend it to have, say, 3 or 4 or 5 buttons or something, that's pretty easy. You just make it wider, copying these structures. If you want to have more combo elements, instead of having 5 elements, you know, 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, that's 5 elements. If you want 7, that's pretty easy. You just copy and paste this a couple more times. If you want it much longer than that, or many or more buttons than that, you're gonna have to mess around with adding repeaters in to refresh signal strength, and that might mess with some timings. So you'll have to play around with that to make sure that the timings are all good. But actually, it shouldn't be too hard. But it's very extensible, and I think it's pretty easy to understand. So that's how it works. Let's enter one more time, just for fun. 3, 2, 1. That's about it. Thanks for watching.